Hello, hello. Oh, it's not working. Hello, hello, hello again. Welcome again to another reaction on the channel. And today we'll be watching 15 Craziest Natural Phenomena Recorded on Camera by The Finest. All the details in the description box below. And let's just jump into it.
This earth is filled with wonderful and bizarre occurrences that we're often left unable to explain.
With the fire,
so many of these events being very rare, we are often left without any ability to experience these natural events. From the starling flocks phenomena to Pele's hair, here are 15 craziest natural phenomena recorded on camera. Number 15. Starling flocks phenomena. On its own, a starling doesn't cause a lot of problems. It's a bird the size of a tennis ball with feathers that have a dark, velvety hue.
Okay.
In any case, the starling creates stunning designs in an unusually marvelous fashion, as starlings gather in flocks numbering into the hundreds of thousands over open fields to produce an effect that makes it look like art from another dimension. Converging around each other, guided by the wind and instinct, the dark forms in flight are an expression of reality that appears to be inspired by an attraction to entropy.
Sound of it, though.
The question that doesn't have an obvious answer is why. The aerial patterns of birds are constantly moving, giving each bird an ideal view of their surroundings. Birds, including starlings themselves, frequently group into large flocks to defend themselves from birds of prey. The more numbers in a flock, the less likely each bird would be caught by wild predators. Yet starling flocks also fly in such formations when there are no predators near them. That doesn't explain the full story and leaves many questions. Do you know
Hello,
why
Millie?
The starling flock phenomenon
occurs? Shadow. Again.
Before we go on, like this video, smash the subscribe button and click the notification bell right now, or this centipede will crawl on your face when you're sleeping.
Kind of far from the place where I'm leaving, though.
Number 14. Pele's hair. Sometimes life is a bit too hot to handle. Yet, when things cool down and you start getting a grip on things, what's left can be quite wonderful to behold. This leads us to the term Pele's hair, which is essentially a form of fiber that is cooled down to a kind of molten glass that forms out of the lava, and because of the speed at which the lava lengthens.
Never heard about it before.
It's kind of like canned spaghetti, except thinner, with less sauce, and a little firmer. Because of this, the lava cools in small, thin threads. Pele's hair fibers can be several meters long and just a fraction of a millimeter in diameter.
These
fibers are then transported away by the breeze. They can be taken away a few kilometers from the vents. Where the wind blows, Pele's hair will follow. Will you be there to catch it? The next time you think of heating up your spaghetti in a microwave, take a moment
to contemplate the memory of
Pele's hair. When it's finished blowing in the wind, lay at rest in peace. Pieces. Number 13. Eternal Flame Falls. There's a little waterfall called the Everlasting Flame Falls. Whether the falls will be everlasting or not is a questionable statement. It sounds like a meditative space with sacred meaning. The Eternal Flame Falls Valley is an iconic and unusual waterfall that is potentially quite a dangerous environment.
I guess that's a methane?
The waterfall is named because of a simple phenomenon, a natural gas spill right below the waterfall, which just happens to ignite. The flame is not necessarily eternal in the way that it often goes out. It's also relit by passengers, because while the gas is natural, the flames being ignited are affected by the passersby. The falls emit natural gas, which has the smell of rotten eggs. Truly a wonderful aroma that sets the tone.
Yep.
The gases produced during the decomposition of the organics within the rock deposits are under pressure and push out through cracks and loose layers within the rock. It's unbelievable that the pressure of the gas outlet over time doesn't cause the rock to burst. The place where water and fire meet. Isn't it fascinating? fascinating that something like this is even possible?
It's good.
Number 12. Desert Rose really cool. Selenite, meaning and properties. Gypsum Rose. Imagine a rose as a gift given to someone special made completely out of sand. That's the Desert Rose Selenite, shaped by water, wind, and sand that develops over a few hundred years.
300 years? Wow.
The wind will continuously blow on the selenite that embeds the sand in the blades. With time, the water tends to create a rose-like shape. Some cultures say that the desert rose invokes the properties of mental insight, energy cleansing, and inner reality.
Desert
rose helps to rid the mind of old thought processes and opening up the flow of guidance from your intuition. It would be interesting to know what a chemist would say about the organic structure of the desert rose and how it affects humans. My guess, if something like this makes a difference, it has something to do with electrons and positive and negative electric charges. Regardless of the thoughts behind how a desert rose came to be and what it does for the mind and body, there's no denying that it is a beautiful natural art. An incredible thing to be able to see with our own eyes and a testament to the beauty in life. Number 11. Bioluminescent Wave. Illuminating the night, the bioluminescent wonder
That's
is
cool.
absolutely stunning in its beauty. The ocean can shine like the stars in the sky thanks to a natural chemical process known as bioluminescence, which allows living things to produce light in their bodies. With the generation and release of light from a living organism, it's kind of an organic cocktail with the combination of colors creating an illuminating and brilliant result. The bioluminescent sea will glow when disturbed by a wave breaking or a splash in the water at night. I reckon out of all the incredible and unique things related to the ocean, visually, this is definitely at the top for the human eye. Marine creatures, either to confuse predators with disarray or to attract prey with illusion or even to attract potential mates with this inviting phenomenon. Using the manipulation of light to survive in the wilderness. Isn't it incredible how natural creatures even utilize organic light manipulation processes to survive? Could you imagine a gigantic glowing wave rising above the sky with marine creatures swimming and lighting up the night? How incredibly poetic. Number 10. Penitente's Spiky Snow Formation in the Andes. Some of the coolest things in the world are not usually experienced by the human eye. Interestingly, the phenomenon called Penitentes is formed at very high altitude glaciers, where the air is dry and the blanket of protection that covers the ground level from the ruthless heat of the sun. Snow will develop into impressive thin ice blades up in the freezing cold icy mountaintops, growing up to a few meters tall.
The giant Penitentes. Amazing, amazing view.
A pretty cool natural event, wouldn't you say? One could even say that it's sort of like a forest in the mountains with huge frozen water trees. Kind of like an elegant crystallized pine tree. Ugh, all this ice talk freezes the socks off. They take the form of tall, thin blades of frozen snow or ice, closely spaced with blades pointed towards the general direction of light. These pinnacles of snow or ice are rising at incredibly high altitudes in the glacial and snow-covered regions. Blue hues on a golden sunset, the tops of the mountains like a spear striking fiercely into the sky. When night falls on this icy, spiky battlefield, the conflict rages between the elements. Number 9. Fire World. There aren't many things as relaxing as staring into a fire on a nice, cool evening contemplating life. However, another fascinating option for the fire lovers out there are fire worlds. They present a strong intensification of combustion, usually during large urban and wildfires.
That's a big one, though.
However, they are obscured with many features. A mixture of wind and fuel to produce something like a sandstorm, but with fire and smoke. A scorching heat that looks pretty awesome, but is vicious. They are not understood well, with most understanding coming from a laboratory as they're very dangerous to approach, due to the high strength and force and temperature of the flames, also the destructive powers of the momentum that acts like a wind funnel. The best guess at understanding this epic reaction is really a combination of just about everything you would expect, between heat and wind, geometry, and gravity. The natural reaction of high winds and a large fuel source pushing the flames to desolate the surrounding area. The end product is still a mysterious whirlwind that carries with it the fury of nature's wrath, with aesthetics that make the jaw drop because it's not something you see every day, perhaps even in an entire lifetime. Number 8. Snow rollers. It looks like snow rolls itself into big, donut-shaped snowballs. But instead of going to a bakery, you're going to a frozen field of icy fascination. This elegant natural art showcases a wonderful display.
Is that the person there? That's been the massive, aren't they?
The grace and sophistication of the mesmerizing funnel, the swelling mix of ice and snow, which spirals in such an organized manner. Huh. It's a phenomenon that exists only in optimal circumstances. Kind of like frying an egg. If you leave it too long, it'll burn. Turn it at the right time, it'll have the right texture. And if you don't heat it for long enough, it just won't harden. The perfect conditions for a snow roller to be able to shape requires a light snow dust that's moist enough to stick to the ground, but loose enough so it doesn't adhere. Wind speeds must be high enough to force the snow down the ice so that it coils up into a signature snow roller style. Looking like a wave breaking overhead, about to trap the unconscious surfer frozen. The shape is really something exquisite that nature has been able to produce. It's a wonder that there aren't any ice creams designed with this in mind. Number 7.
That's a good idea.
Morocco's tree climbing goats. Why is it that if you see something unusual going on, it's usually a goat in the center of the thick of it? This is what seems to be going on here, as the goat climbed up to get a bird's eye view of the nearby landscape. I can't tell you why it's.
In all fairness, I'm kind of surprised why is it such a surprise to people. Marrakesh, like, the goats in the mountains are.
A type of tree.
They can go on the vertical. With no problem. So why would the tree be a problem for them?
It's rust colored, eschewing a landscape that harbors many unusual things, including the strangest tree-climbing mammals, not letting any hooves get in the way. Argan trees grow a fruit that is reminiscent of a crushed olive. It ripens around June every year. The crafty, ingenious goats, hungry for the bitter taste and scent, will climb the argan tree at a chance.
It's argan as in argan oil for hair?
Thorny branches, no. And although they may not be pretty, they draw a lot of attention from fans, including herds of starving goats that are in their crooked roots, often more than a dozen in a single tree.
They're really high too.
Number 6. Dust storm. During high gale winds, the wind's vicious energy moves over loosely hitting particles with enough force to counter the gravity keeping them down. This increases the sand particles' movements. They tend to vibrate at first, then later travel over the surface. With a loosening roar and rocking force, they repeatedly touch the ground, loosening up and breaking down all the tiny dust particles. Which then continue to travel in suspension. At wind rates above what allows the smallest to be suspended, there would be a population of dust grains going. Sand and dust storms typically arise as strong winds with a building momentum, lifting vast quantities of sand and dust from bare, dry surfaces to the atmosphere that would otherwise be stagnant. Over the past decade, awareness is rising at the effects that humanity has had on the quantity and impact that we have on causing these destructive events to occur. There's only so much you can do to.
Can you imagine what kind of mess it is if you forget, like, leave the window open?
Monsters, the dust storm. What would you do if you were stuck in the middle of a dust storm? Number 5.
Depending on what might be in the car or walking.
Many hypotheses have emerged throughout the years on the nature and purpose of these deep, dark blue holes. The mystery is almost as awesome as the outcome. The explanation for this is that they are very difficult to quantify and measure using current ordinary intellectual resources. An interesting point. The debate is out whether they should be a protected area since they have allowed marine life to flourish. Being sheltered away from the open ocean, they foster a huge array of organic, habitual sea life. One of the coolest things about them, aside from the rich and flourishing abundance of life, is that when you look directly down on a blue hole, there is a color discrepancy between the rest of the ocean and the circular blue hole, which leads deep into the sea floor. Can you imagine what it would be like to be that deep underwater in a swimsuit? The pressure would be crushing, you wouldn't be able to see anything, and everything would want to eat you. No thanks, I'm good. Perhaps let the sea be the sea, and I'll be focusing on seeing things with my own two eyes on dry land. What do you think? Are you game for a dive in a deep blue hole?
Number I don't know, I've never dived before, so it's hard to...
Bioluminescent forest. Mysterious things always seem to happen at night
really?
While we
Where's
are asleep.
That?
Unlike the horrors that we hear of in other scenarios, however, this wonderful and resonating environment comes to life. The jungles of the Maharashtra Bhimshankar Wildlife Reserve are approximately 100 kilometers east of Mumbai. When every step leaves you with another dose of anxiety, all those insects can sense your
That's
fear
for real?
And the big predators lay
really?
In wait, hoping to snatch you up and digest you. Why would anybody enter this fearsome jungle? The monsoon season allows the leeches, the slippery slopes, and the rain to thrive. It's the best time of year for the bioluminescent forest to come to life. Incessant downpour brought the bleak and rugged terrain to life in a bright hue of green.
I have a feeling this is not
New
real.
New grass coated almost every inch of the typically dark scenery. And yet, in the midst of this hidden vast conclave is a secret. When the night comes along, the lights turn on, and the beauty of this mysterious and incredible jungle comes to life with vivid and stunning echoing acoustics. Would you take on the wonder of a forest that is alive with color akin to a paradise hidden in the depths if it included potential health risks that could paralyze you or worse? Number 3. Taos Hum. In the dry, dusty, quiet town of Taos, a relaxed arts community located in the north-central region of New Mexico, is apparently an odd mystery. A resident hum of uncertain origin, the so-called Taos Hum. Critics of this claim will say that humans live in a continuous sea of background noise, so it's not really a surprise that there would be frequencies that the human ear would find uncomfortable in a certain area. Also, low frequencies travel further, so it would be expected that some sensitive ears would be able to hear a faint, low-frequency note. Secondly, there are hundreds of possible sources of noise, including traffic, ships, aircraft, insects, massive machinery, wind, freight trains, mines, and other industries.
It's that sort of a sound.
Superstitious protagonists would argue that although many people can believe that it should be easy to find the source of the sound, it may be very difficult in reality. A really vast combination of ideas has been offered as the reason, ranging from the mundane to the fantastic, the disjointed, psychological, to the creepy paranormal. Every story you can imagine under the sun has been thought up to as to why these people claim to experience these noises. Number 2. Mematis Clouds.
Mematis
is quite fascinating. Could be worth looking up the origin of the name. The brilliance of this bizarre pattern is not something that the average human can comprehend entirely. Mematis clouds are clouds that form a very strange pattern, quite like bubble wrap. Depending on the color of the backdrop, the view will change in appearance, and often is very stunning. Although it can seem quite frightening in the right conditions, as if the sky was falling on your head. They're somewhat argued to form pockets of sinking air. Protruding from an overhanging wave of clouds, they usually come with a thunderstorm as company.
Mm-hmm.
Being cold, most of these clouds are made of ice. Consider wearing a hard helmet just in case. Each mematis cloud has the ability to last for up to 10 to 15 minutes and can reach very long lengths. People equate them with extreme weather. They're interesting in part because they're created by sinking weather. Although there's a large amount of unnecessary superstition attached to them, mematis clouds can look ominous and foreboding, so it's easy to see why people get worked up about them. Yet, in a way that's so normal in nature, their dangerous presence goes hand in hand with majestic elegance. Number 1. Monarch Butterfly Migration.
actually went to see them, but it was too... The temperature was just perfect for them to fly away, so we haven't seen even one single butterfly.
The setting in which they find themselves. After an upbringing, the monarch is finally ready to spread its wings
and fly. It's a bit disappointing, but still.
On a journey to a distant land, which is up to 2,000 miles away.
And to fly a great distance is a mystery.
The only butterfly known to do a two-way type of migration, similar to the migration of long-distance traveling birds. Unable to survive freezing temperatures like other butterflies, the monarch butterflies have the ability to sense that the air is getting too cold for them through environmental sensory hints, and so they prepare for their long voyage of safety and security. The great risk is that they are very sensitive to the temperature, and so any sharp change can cause them to literally die.
No.
They are very fragile and wonderful insects for the human being to experience. Have you ever seen the monarch butterfly migration in your life?
Nope.
Is it incredible to witness?
It would be.
What do you think of our 15 craziest natural phenomena recorded on camera? Have you been able to film or see any incredibly rare natural phenomena in your life? Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up.
Well, what did you think about it? That was interesting. The one about the bioluminescence forest thing. I'm kind of at 50-50 that's real. Okay, thanks for watching and I'll see you tomorrow. And don't forget to, you know, I don't know, like, comment, subscribe. See ya. Bye.